the leaf spring suspension. Basic design of a leaf spring. The leaf spring is a basic form of suspension, which is made up of steel layers of different sizes, sandwiched on top of another. The steel is usually cut into rectangular sections, and then secured once with metal clamps. The leaf spring is fixed to the axle housing, by a large U-shaped bolt. Rubber bushings are used on the front and rear, to reduce the impact from the road. A damper is also fixed in a clamp, to dissipate the stored energy from the spring. The end of the leaf spring is directly connected to the frame by a shackle. How the leaf spring works. Most leaf springs are made in an elliptical shape using spring steel, which has the properties of allowing it to bend when pressure is applied at both ends, and then return to its original position through a damping process. The elasticity of the spring steel makes the suspension flexible, which can provide comfort and control when the car is driving. For decades, the leaf spring has proven to be a viable suspension system. It is common for many cars to use leaf springs as a dependent rear suspension. The advantage. Compared to coil springs and shock absorbers, leaf springs are simple in design, and have low production cost. Mono leaf spring is the simplest design, using only one leaf of spring, also called a parabolic leaf spring, that tapers from the middle thickness to the edge, to properly distribute the vertical load. Due to the large number of metal layers put together, the leaf springs provide great support between the wheels, axles and chassis of the car. Because of their tight-knit structure, they can withstand the huge vertical loads imposed on them, which is why they are still used in heavy industries. The vertical load is also distributed along the leaf spring, instead of sharply distributed through small springs and shock absorbers, which may generate too much concentrated force that the suspension cannot handle. The disadvantage. The big downside of leaf setups is that they are not brilliant when it comes to adjusting the suspension. In racing and high-performance automotive applications, being able to manipulate the suspension settings for different driving conditions is essential, and this is much easier to achieve with coil spring and shock absorbers. The fact that the end of the leaf spring is connected to the chassis leaves little room to shorten or extend the leaves. Therefore, it is only possible to adjust the strength and flexibility of the material that makes up the leaf springs. The leaf setups also allow few directions of motion, and are only really designed for vertical movement, while the coil spring and damper combination can be manipulated over a wider range of motion. The leaf springs are firmly clamped together and bolted to the chassis, as there is almost no room for any other direction of movement. This can cause severe wear on the joints and connections that hold the setup together. Nowadays, the popularity of leaf springs has declined dramatically, but is still commonly used in heavy industry vehicles.